We live in a world with an unprecedented amount of data, which elevates big data analytics and data science to fundamental questions in decision making. Data science aims at answering two types of questions: predictive questions on the one hand, and causal questions on the other hand. An example of a predictive question is the following: will it rain tomorrow? The regular person doesn't care about why it's going to rain tomorrow. She only cares about whether it will rain tomorrow, so that she knows if she needs to take an umbrella or leave earlier for work to avoid problems with traffic jams. In fact, I am told that the atmospheric models used to predict whether it's going to rain tomorrow are actually rather complicated. The regular person doesn't care about these models, doesn't need to know how these models work. She just cares with a final estimate of how likely it is that it's going to rain tomorrow. And that's what you and I take away from these models as final consumers. However, causal questions are of a different nature. An example of a causal question is the following: how will the sales of my product change if I change the price of the product? Or, for example, how will the temperature on Earth change if we were to start geoengineering in scale next year? These kinds of questions, causal questions, are set up in a different way, in a way that how one change triggers another change. Can big data help answer these kinds of questions? And if so, how? Well, like in any field of knowledge, the answer is yes and no. Big data analytics is likely to help answer these kinds of questions, but it's unlikely to be the silver bullet that you may expect. In fact, many people across many organizations believe these days that more and more data can actually address all kinds of empirical problems, and that is simply not true. In fact, more data costs more to collect, to store, curate, and analyze, and might provide misleading results unless the data are treated carefully and manipulated very carefully. Let me give you just a simple example. Imagine I want to learn how the sales of a product are going to change with price. This is a basic managerial question. But if I use historical data and I plot sales against price, I find a positive relationship between these two variables. The higher the price, the more the sales, which we know it's not true. The problem is that price conceals information about the quality of the product. And within a certain range of reasonable prices, the more the quality of the product, the higher the sales, regardless of the price. And so we find this positive relationship between price and sales, which we know it's not true. In fact, the only way to find a true relationship between price and sales is to set up price in a way that is independent of everything else in the world. How do we do that? How do we can actually set a price in a way that is unrelated to everything else in the world, even things that we don't know about? Well, I would like to convince you that what we need to do is to use randomness. Imagine that the product can be sold at $5.99 and at $9.99. So let's use a coin. And let's offer the product at $5.99 to consumers that get tails, and let's offer the product at $9.99 to consumers that get heads. And if you think this is unfair, you can choose another product and switch the consumers. My point here is that setting a price this way, it's the only way to actually find the true causal effect of price on sales. If you actually just collect more and more data from settings where price is not randomized this way, it's not going to help you solve the question. Let me give you another example. Let's imagine that I'm interested in learning whether giving internet access in schools helps students learn. How do I actually test this hypothesis? Well, I need a random set of schools to have access to the internet and another random set of schools not to have access to the internet and compare them. This might be potentially unfair for a while, but indeed the only way to find the true causal effect of internet access in schools on the performance of students. So my point today is to tell you that if you want to find the causal effect of X on Y, you need to randomize X for a while. Many institutions, both public and private, are increasingly resorting to these types of experiments to find the true causal effects of interest to them. And the ones that do not are lagging behind because they lack the proper knowledge to realize their missions. Of course, it's not always possible to run randomized experiments. For example, if having an ID card affects employability would require me to offer ID cards to a random set of the population, which isn't feasible. Yet, more and more we run randomized experiments in domains that otherwise we thought it would be impossible. So I leave with a challenge to spark the discussion that we're going to have following these presentations. Why don't you think about the causal question of interest to you, related to your job, to your work? And how would you go about setting up a randomized experiment to answer that question once you go back from Dalian, from the World Economic Forum? So thank you for your time today. I look forward to the discussion. Thank you.